This week on the special of the week, Michelob presents Billy Joel.
Don't ask me why.
Billy Joel. He's no doctor, but he cures what ails.
I haven't cured cancer or anything. I mean, I haven't done anything that deserves the adulation.
Everybody's talking about the new sound. Funny, but it's true. Rock the road to me.
Billy Joel. This week on the Robert W. Morgan Special of the Week. Brought to you by Michelob. And now Michelob hopes you enjoy the Special of the Week.
My first selection will be the Chopin Etude. Hey, I didn't graduate high school, okay? So, I'm as nervous as some of you are about this.
I'm not nervous. I'm Robert W. Morgan. This week on the Special of the Week, the Piano Man strikes a new chord. He's become America's biggest-selling male vocalist, and yet he's never sold out by staying just the way he was. When you expect him to croon another ballad, he belts out a rocker. When you expect him to sing about another Italian rendezvous, he sings a song in French. And when you expect his success to make him more mild-mannered and reserved, he remains straightforward because he never tempers his candor. About the only thing you can expect from him is the unexpected. And yet, he's still Billy Joel to me.
What's the matter with the clothes I'm wearing? Can't you tell that your tie's too wide? Maybe I should buy some old tab collars. Welcome back to the age of jive. Where have you been hiding out lately, honey? You can't dress as flashy till you spend a lot of money. Everybody's talking about the new sound. Funny, but it's still rock and roll to me. What's the matter with the car I'm driving? Can't you tell that it's out of style? Should I get a set of white wall tires? Are you gonna cruise the miracle mile? Nowadays you can't be too sentimental. The best get the true baby blue continental. Hot funk, cool funk. Even if it's old junk, still rock and roll to me. Oh, it doesn't matter what you say in the papers, 'cause it's always been the same old theme. There's a new thing in town, but you can't get the sound from the story in a magazine. Hey, that's your average team. If you just give it half a chance. Don't waste your money on a new set of speakers. You get all mileage from a cheap pair of sneakers. Mix face, new way, dance great. Anyway, it's still rock and roll to me.
New sound, funny, but it's true,
rock the road to me.
Well, I'm rolling, don't stop me, man. I like a lot of the new stuff, I think it's real healthy. It's like back to basics. It basically comes down to songs. What they call new wave, I don't believe is new, new wave to me is a phony title. To me it's reactionary music, it's going back to the 60s, I don't think it's new at all. I think it's stripping it away and bringing it back to basic rock and roll, which isn't new or progressive, it's reactionary. But in a way, I think that's good. The music is kind of cleansing itself.
Billy Joel, as you'll hear in both a rare one-on-one interview and when we caught him in the act live in New York, his comments may cause a reaction, but he's never reactionary. Still, Billy reacts strongly against fame and fortune. In fact, against anything that even smacks of jive. And yet, in It's Still Rock and Roll to Me, Billy welcomes us back to the age of jive. Why?
The age of jive. I don't buy it. I really don't buy it. I have to deal with it. my people will go, can I have your autograph, I mean, I'd be the same way with people I idolize. If I ever met Paul McCartney, I'd probably faint. And I'd react the same way, but I haven't cured cancer or anything. I mean, I haven't done anything that deserves the adulation. I take it with a grain of salt. I'm cynical about it. I am skeptical about it. I think it keeps me healthy, though. You know, if I ever really started believing that I was as great as people think I am, then it'd be all over. That's it. That's that, Jack.
Well, you went uptown riding in your limousine with your fine Paul Gallant clothes. You had the dog hair and yarn in your hand and the spoon up your nose. Ooh, when you wake up in the morning with your head on fire and your eyes too bloody to see.
Now, if you believe everything you read about you,
wow, you really believe in your own
baloney, you know? And if you believe the good things and you get swelled up about them, then you're going to believe the bad things and get depressed about them. Sometimes I go to a bar and I'll give you an autograph, oh, please, kiss me, it's my birthday, kiss me! And after I say, okay, all right. I just want to have a quiet drink, but there's still places like, I don't shave and I eat garlic, you know? I get bombed out. That can't be him. You know, he wouldn't be here. You could pull all kinds of stuff. I go to Yankee Stadium and I wear a hat and a ripped T-shirt. Looks like Billy Joel. Are you Billy Joel? No, I'm Billy.
Little Gio is a friend of mine. We get some money and we buy a cheap wine. Sit on the corner and have a holiday. Bottle when the cop goes by. Talk about women and lie. Oh, my other world is just a half a mile away. Wait for mama to turn out the light. Crawl on the roof and then I hit the night. I should be sleeping, but tonight I just can't stay. I've given everybody so much time. Now I need a moment that's my. Oh, my other world is just a half a mile away.
Joel's a rock raconteur, a master storyteller. You hear it when he speaks, and you can hear it in his music. He's a street life serenader, and it seems as if anyone and everyone he meets turns up in his tunes.
When I talk about one character, it's not always cut and dried one particular person. It's based maybe on one person, but it's also a whole lot of other people who've had the same experience. When I write a love song about a woman, I suppose most people assume that it's about my wife. You know, I love my wife, but she represents women to me. And when I write a love song, it's not just for my wife. It's about a lot of women in general. Like a song like Just the Way You Are, it's like a painter. It's like the Renoir, Degas, or Impressionists. They would use their mistress as a model for a painting, but it wasn't necessarily just their mistress. It represented a woman in a certain feeling. That's the way I write.
Don't go changing to try to please me. You never let me down before. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore.
could have come this far? I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, I take you just the way you are. Don't go trying some new fashion, don't change the color of your hair. Always have my unspoken passion, although I might not seem to care. I don't want clever conversation, never want to work that hard. I just want someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are. You need to know that you will always be the same old someone that I knew. I promise from the heart, I couldn't love you any better. I love you just the way you can talk to. I want you just the way you are.
Billy Joel loves it at Levittown. Next on the special of the week, I'm Robert W. Morgan. Robert W. Morgan with Billy Joel on the special of the week.
My real name is Joel. William Martin Joel. That's my real name. I grew up in Hicksville, Long Island, which is, you know about Levittown? You know what Levittown is? It's like Xerox tract housing.
Houses weren't the only things being duplicated in Billy Joel's neighborhood. He and his friends were mock punks, copying the tough guy stance of young hoods they'd seen in West Side Story. But even as a kid, Billy was an original.
Because I was a musician, I straddled a couple of different cliques. I used to go out with girls who were collegiates because they were cheerleaders and they were cute. And I used to hang out with people who were in the bohemian beatnik clique because they were intelligent. It wasn't cool to be smart if you were what you call a greaser. You had to be stupid and talk like this. So I had friends in that clique too, you know, people who read, because I read a lot. I didn't grow up with a TV, so I read. I was a bookish person. And the people who were the brownies, I don't think I got along with them at all.
There's a place in the world for the angry young man with his working class ties and his radical plan. He refuses to bend, he refuses to crawl, and he's always at home with his back to the wall. And he's proud of his scars and the battles he's fought, and he struggles to believe that he hangs on a cross. And he likes to be known as the angry young man. A moment or two to the angry young man, with his foot in his mouth and his heart in his hand. He's been stabbed in the back, he's been misunderstood. It's a comfort to know his intentions are good. And he sits in a room with a lock on the door, with his maps and his medals laid out on the floor. And he likes to be known as the angry young man. I believe I've passed the age, consciousness and righteous rage. I found that just surviving was a noble fight. I once believed in causes too. I had my pointless point of view. And life went on no matter who was the wrong or right. Oh, the thought of the grave has been angry old.
His ability to communicate with kids from all kinds of cliques would come in handy as a songwriter. That's because Billy Joel's songs touch you where you live, no matter where you're from. And as a young piano student with dreams of becoming a songwriter, Billy always knew exactly where he was coming from.
The first song I wrote was terrible. If I remember that, I wouldn't even tell you. It was early 60s. It was like a bad Beatles song, you know. I'll tell you. Real crap song. Well, I climb the highest mountain, and I swim the deepest sea. Heavy, huh? If I knew you, it's called My Journey's End. At my journey's end, waiting for me. Well, you gotta start somewhere. You gotta, but it never ended up being me.
He was an amateur boxer when he was growing up, and he hasn't pulled any punches since. Songs like Movin' Out are wry comments on the suburban anxieties he felt in his youth, on the philosophy that says if you aren't making it fast in the material world, then you're only faking it.
I went to visit Vienna. My father lived there, and it was a city where old people seemed to be pretty content, and they were still working, and they were fairly happy. It was kind of an old way of life. We tend to treat old people pretty crappy. We tend to try to push them aside and not think about them and not deal with them here. When you get to be 20, you know, from that age of 20 to 45, you said, gotta hurry, gotta make it, hurry up quick, because when you're 45, you haven't made it, you know, it's all over and it's over the hill. What I meant by that was you don't have to try to live your whole life between the age of 20 and, you know, 45, which is supposed to be your prime earning years. You know, there's a whole life to live. Vienna meant a nice old age, a happy old age, a productive old age is what I mean by Vienna.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old. You're gonna
kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you?
Vienna, not Vegas, waits for Billy Joel. Even though he's only in his early 30s, Billy's prepared for a productive old age.
From the time I knew I could support myself, I knew from that time on, no matter what happens with records or charts or anything, I can always make a living. I can go to any piano bar at any time and make a living. I'll never go to Las Vegas, you know, and do, you know, and here he is, the piano man himself. I mean, that's like my worst nightmare. Hey, how you doing? Hey, a guy goes to the doctor, right? You know, you know, have Shecky Green open up for me. I mean, that kind of. No, you know, no thanks. But I could do the Holiday Inn circuit at any time because I can fake enough and I got a good enough veneer to spot, you know, an Italian guy coming through and Italian guy. And, you know, boom, and I'll make union scale, and I'll put a buck in the brandy glass, and I'll make a living. I don't worry about it.
It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. A regular crowd shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to his tonic and gin. John at the bar is a friend of mine. He gets me my drinks for free. And he's quick with a joke or to light up your smoke. But there's some place that he'd rather be. Talking with David, who's still in the Navy, and probably will be polite. Thank you.
charming to see, to forget about life for a while.
Joel becomes a reluctant entertainer. Next on the special of the week, I'm Robert W. Moore.